Hello guys, in this video we'll be finding out what are the differences and similarities between linear and logistic regression. This is one of the most frequently asked questions and candidates usually makes mistake and gets confused on what points to highlight between these two algorithms. So let us find out what are the key points which you can remember and explain it to the interviewer. So first we'll look into the similarities. So one of the key similarity is that both of the algorithm assumes a parametric form relating the predictors to the response. Now if you have to ask me what is a parametric form, in simple language it is when a model assumes something about the data. And a non-parametric form is that when the algorithm does not assumes anything from the data. Some of the non-parametric algorithms are as linear regression, logistic regression, simple neural networks. And some of the non-parametric machine learning algorithms are such as decision trees, random forest, boosting algorithms. Now both of them come from a supervised learning background. Now supervised learning background can be known as an algorithm which has a supervisor. So here we have a target variable that act as a supervisor. Next is the model fit is almost done in a similar manner in both of the algorithm. So in the first one we use ordinary least square equation. And in the second one, that is the logistic regression, we use maximum likelihood. Both of them predicts values, hence both of them are known as regression. One of them, which is logistic regression, the predicted value are the probability which lies between 0 and 1. And linear regression is again values. Both of them can be used to converge using gradient descent. Gradient descent is an algorithm which helps us minimize the loss function or the cost function. Now let us look at the most common dissimilarities between the two. Now two major differences between these two algorithms can be highlighted. So one of them is, as I said in the previous slide, is linear regression uses ordinary least square and logistic regression uses maximum likelihood estimation. Hence, the analysis of residuals are also very different. So the concept of log loss, which was introduced in the previous video, can be applied here. In logistic regression, we use log loss, or also known as cross entropy, to reduce the loss function. And of course, in linear regression, we use max mean squared error or root mean squared error to reduce the loss function. Now, the key ideas for logistic regression is we expect the outcome to be binary. Usually it will be head or tail, the email is a spam or ham, 0 or 1, the person will default in the loan or will not default. We transform the model so that it fits a linear model, right? In the last video we saw how we are transforming it to a more expensive linear fit. In the right hand side we have the log odds of y, and in the left hand side we have the linear form, which is beta naught plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2. Logistic regression is computationally fast and it also causes less of overfitting. Since the model is very simpler, it is much more generalizable, so it causes less of overfitting. Again, sigmoid curve is used to fit the data. The loss function is also called log loss or cross entropy. Next, we'll find out what are the best resources to learn more about this algorithm. Of course, my videos are there. Second is Andrew NGO YouTube videos. Most of my content, what I have learned, is from YouTube videos, and Andrew NGO has been a very amazing part of my videos. O'Reilly books, of course, books can provide you much more information than any YouTube videos. I would definitely suggest you guys to go and look up the books. most of them are available and they are not very pricey. But in case if you guys are looking for more books, just comment down below and I'll send you the soft copy of the books. So again, few of the papers of logistic regression which I'll be discussing in the coming videos are very important and which can give you a very brief background about the algorithm, and at the same time you can learn much more about other algorithms like LDA, which is linear discriminant analysis. Hence I would really suggest you to go and read research papers and books. So this was all for today's video. Let me know in the comments what you think, and in case if you want any of the books, again let me know in the comments. I'll definitely send you the ebooks of them. Thank you.